In the shadowy corners of our world, unnerving tales lurk, waiting to send a shiver down your spine. Welcome to the realm of the uncanny, the eerie, the downright creepy. Today, we delve into the top 10 creepiest places you can actually set foot in. Yes, these are not just stories, but real destinations steeped in mystery and spine-tingling lore. Why these locales, you ask? Well, each holds a unique brand of terror, a chilling narrative that has earned them a spot on our list. From haunted mansions echoing with the past to abandoned asylums whispering tales of despair, these places are not for the faint-hearted. So, buckle up, dear listener, for a journey into the unknown. Prepare to traverse the globe and plunge into the eerie depths of these haunting destinations. Remember, the stories you'll hear are as real as the chill that will run down your spine. So are you ready to experience the unsettling, the uncanny, the utterly creepy? Then stay tuned as we embark on this spine-chilling adventure. And remember, these tales are not just to be heard, but to be shared, to be talked about, and to be explored. Welcome to the realm of the creepiest places you can actually visit. In the heart of the City of Love, beneath the hustle and bustle of Paris, lies a chilling world of the dead. Welcome to the Catacombs of Paris, our number 10 on the list of haunting destinations. These subterranean tunnels, stretching over 200 miles, are no ordinary catacombs. They are the final resting place of more than 6 million souls, their bones stacked high in a macabre display that's as haunting as it is fascinating. The catacombs came into existence in the late 18th century when Paris was facing a severe crisis due to overflowing cemeteries. The solution? Reclaim the abandoned limestone quarries beneath the city, turning them into an underground ossuary. As you descend the narrow spiral staircase into the labyrinth below, you're greeted by a chilling inscription: "Stop! Here lies the Empire of Death." Imagine yourself wandering through these dark, narrow tunnels, the eerie silence broken only by your footsteps echoing off the walls. Each turn reveals another chamber filled with neatly stacked skulls and bones, a stark reminder of the city's past. The air is heavy with a sense of lost histories, untold stories, and the ever-present specter of death. Urban legends and ghost stories abound in this underworld. Whispered tales of the Green Man, a ghostly figure said to wander the tunnels, and chilling reports of voices whispering in the dark, give the catacombs an added layer of fear. Some brave explorers have even reported feeling an unseen presence, a chilling touch on the shoulder, or an unexplainable chill in the air. So, dear viewer, would you dare to step foot into this haunting underworld to explore the eerie depths of the catacombs of Paris? If you're brave enough, this could be your next adventure. Remember, the chilling tales you hear are not just stories, they're a part of the haunting history of this city, waiting to be explored. As we leave the catacombs of Paris behind, we travel to a hauntingly beautiful location in the land of the rising sun. Welcome to Aokigahara Forest, our number 9 on the list of haunting destinations. This dense, sprawling forest at the base of Mount Fuji is known by many names: the Sea of Trees, the Perfect Place to Die, and most chillingly, the Suicide Forest. Aokigahara has a tragic reputation as one of the world's most prevalent suicide spots, a grim reality that casts a heavy shadow over the forest's breathtaking natural beauty. The forest's association with death is not a recent phenomenon. It finds its roots in Japanese folklore, which teems with tales of yurei, or tormented spirits. Many believe Aokigahara to be a home for these restless souls, adding a layer of supernatural dread to the already somber location. It is said that compasses malfunction due to the high iron content in the volcanic soil, leading some to believe that the forest itself wants to keep you within its grasp. This forest has been controversially portrayed in popular media, both locally and internationally. Some argue that the media's fascination with Aokigahara's dark allure inadvertently romanticizes the act of suicide, leading to an increase in the forest's death toll. The Japanese government and local volunteers have made concerted efforts to combat this, posting numerous signs throughout the forest, urging visitors to think of their families and seek help. Visiting Aokigahara is a uniquely somber experience. The silence here is different from other forests. It's not peaceful, it's heavy, as if the very air is burdened with sorrow. The quiet is occasionally broken by the rustling of wildlife or the somber notes of a wind chime, placed by volunteers in a bid to comfort wandering spirits. For those brave enough to venture into Aokigahara, it's not just a haunting destination, but a stark reminder of the battles many fight within themselves. It's a place that forces us to confront the uncomfortable reality of mental health issues and their consequences. So, dear viewer, would you dare to immerse yourself in the eerie beauty and sorrow of Aokigahara? Remember, the stories you hear are not just tales, they're echoes of real lives and real tragedies. As we bid farewell to Japan's Sea of Trees, we journey to a different kind of haunting destination, one marked by a human-made disaster. Welcome to Chernobyl's exclusion zone, our number 8 on the list. This area in northern Ukraine is a chilling testament to the devastating effects of one of the world's worst nuclear accidents. On April 26, 1986, a routine safety test at the Chernobyl nuclear power plant spiraled out of control, resulting in an explosion and fire that released massive amounts of radioactive material into the environment. The immediate vicinity was evacuated, transforming the bustling city of Pripyat and nearby towns into ghost towns overnight. The Chernobyl exclusion zone, covering an area of approximately 2,600 square kilometers, was established to protect people from the harmful effects of radiation. Despite the grim history, it has become a macabre tourist attraction. Those who dare to visit are met with an eerie silence, broken only by the wind whistling through the abandoned buildings. Nature has slowly begun to reclaim this radioactive wasteland, with wildlife thriving in the absence of human interference, a hauntingly beautiful paradox that underscores the resilience of nature in the face of human folly. Visitors can still see remnants of the lives that were abruptly left behind, decaying dolls in a kindergarten, rusting Ferris wheel in an amusement park, and the infamous reactor number 4 looming ominously in the background. The ghostly city of Pripyat, once home to 50,000 residents, now stands frozen in time, a chilling monument to the dangers of nuclear power. While the area is open to the public, visiting the Chernobyl exclusion zone is not without risks. Tourists are required to obtain a permit, and visits are strictly regulated to minimize exposure to radiation. Dosimeters are provided to monitor radiation levels, and certain areas, like the Red Forest, are completely off-limits due to their dangerously high radiation levels. Despite these precautions, the risks associated with visiting a radioactive zone are very real and should not be taken lightly. So, dear viewer, would you dare to explore the eerie silence and haunting beauty of Chernobyl's exclusion zone? Remember, the desolate landscape you see is not just a tourist attraction, but a solemn reminder of a disaster that claimed countless lives and continues to impact the environment to this day. From the radioactive wastelands of Chernobyl, we transition to a different kind of chilling destination. Welcome to the Island of the Dolls, our number 7 on the list. Tucked away in the canals south of Mexico City, this small island, La Isla de las Muñecas in Spanish, is home to hundreds, if not thousands, of dolls of all shapes and sizes hanging from trees, fences, and buildings. These dolls, weathered by time and the elements with their vacant eyes and decaying bodies, create an unsettling atmosphere that is both fascinating and eerie. The story behind the Island of the Dolls is a tragic one. It all started with a man named Don Julian Santana Barrera, the island's sole inhabitant for over 50 years. He claimed to have found the body of a young girl who drowned in the canal. Haunted by her death, he started hanging dolls around the island as a way to appease her spirit and protect the island from evil. The dolls, however, were not new or pretty. Santana Barrera would collect discarded dolls from the trash and the canals, their worn-out appearance adding to the island's disturbing charm. Visitors to the island often report feeling watched, and some even claim to have heard the dolls whispering. There are stories of dolls moving their heads or limbs, and some visitors swear they have seen the dolls' eyes following them as they move around the island. Whether these are just tricks of the light or something more supernatural, we leave it for you to decide. But the most chilling part of the Island of the Dolls is perhaps the fate of Santana Barrera himself. In 2001, he was found dead, drowned in the same canal where he claimed to have found the girl's body all those years ago. This tragic end only fueled the legend surrounding the island. So, dear viewers, do you have the courage to visit the Island of the Dolls? To walk under the trees adorned with the haunting figures, and perhaps even catch a whisper or a movement from the corner of your eye? Remember, what you see is not just a collection of discarded toys, but a testament to a man's attempt to appease a troubled spirit. The Island of the Dolls is not for the faint-hearted, but for those who dare, it offers a uniquely chilling experience. From the eerie gaze of countless dolls, we take you to Europe's haunting heart, Italy's Pavilia Island, our number 6 on the list. A small patch of land nestled between Venice and Lido, Paveglia's tranquil exterior belies a dark and chilling history. In the 14th century, during the devastating outbreaks of the bubonic plague, Paveglia served as a quarantine station, or lazaretto, for the infected. Thousands of plague victims were forcibly shipped to the island, where they lived their final agonizing days, their bodies eventually burned on giant pyres. The island's soil is said to be composed of 50% human ash, a grim reminder of its tragic past. But the horrors didn't end there. In the early 20th century, Paveglia housed a mental asylum where rumors of cruel medical experiments and lobotomies persist. The asylum's head doctor allegedly tortured patients and conducted inhuman experiments before reportedly going mad and leaping to his death from the hospital's bell tower. Today, the island is abandoned, the decaying buildings and overgrown vegetation standing as silent witnesses to its dreadful history. Visitors are strictly forbidden, but that hasn't stopped the curious and the brave from venturing there. Those who have managed to set foot on Paveglia report chilling encounters, disembodied voices, sudden temperature drops, and even apparitions. Many believe the island is haunted by the tormented souls of its past, unable to find peace. But what secrets does Paveglia truly hold? Beneath the rusted iron and crumbling stone in the ashes of the departed, what tales of horror and despair are yet to be unearthed? Paveglia Island, with its forbidden allure, is not for the faint-hearted. But for those drawn to the mysteries of the past, the intrigue of the unknown, it beckons with a chilling whisper. Are you brave enough to uncover what lies beneath its haunted shores? Remember, dear viewers, every grain of soil, every rusted hinge holds a story, a fragment of Paveglia's tragic past. This is not just an island, but a silent testament to human suffering and resilience. Be warned, Paveglia is a journey into the heart of darkness itself. From the chilling whispers of Paveglia, we journey eastwards, away from the haunted shores of Italy, and into the fiery heart of Central Asia. Welcome to our number 5 on the list, the Darvaza gas crater, more ominously known as the Door to Hell, in the distant lands of Turkmenistan. In the midst of the Karakum Desert, a blazing pit of fire roars with untamed fury. The Darvaza gas crater, a 230 feet wide and 66 feet deep inferno, has been burning continuously for nearly 5 decades. This fiery spectacle was born out of a Soviet-era gas exploration accident in 1971. When a drilling rig punctured a cavern filled with natural gas, the ground beneath it collapsed, creating a gaping hole. To prevent the spread of methane gas, geologists set the crater alight, expecting it to burn out within weeks. But the flames refused to die, and the Door to Hell was born. Today it stands as a surreal testament to the human endeavor and its unintended consequences. The sight of the crater at night is a spectacle to behold. A fiery abyss in the heart of the desert, its flames dancing against the starlit sky, casting an eerie glow for miles around. The heat can be felt from a distance, a stark reminder of the untamed power beneath the Earth's surface. The Door to Hell is a haunting spectacle, a mesmerizing yet terrifying beacon in the barren desert landscape. Legends and folklore have since enveloped this fiery pit. Some locals believe it to be a gateway to the underworld, a cautionary tale of the Earth's wrath. Despite the harsh environment and the scorching heat, the site has become a magnet for adventurous tourists seeking the thrill of the unknown. So, dear viewers, as you gaze upon the dancing flames of the Door to Hell, consider the stories it holds. What does this fiery spectacle mean to you? Is it a testament to human folly, a symbol of nature's wrath, or a beacon of otherworldly beauty? As we delve deeper into our list of haunting destinations, remember that each place holds a story of mystery, history, and sometimes, a spark of the supernatural. The Door to Hell awaits, its flames ready to tell their fiery tale. Will you dare to listen? Our journey takes a sharp turn now, from the blazing heat of Turkmenistan's Door to Hell to the chilling cold stones of our number 4 haunting destination, the Tower of London, England. This historic castle on the north bank of the River Thames holds a dark and bloody history. Founded towards the end of 1066 as part of the Norman conquest of England, the White Tower, which gives the entire complex its name, was built by William the Conqueror in 1078. But it's not the architecture that casts a shadow over this majestic fortress. The Tower of London is most notorious for its gruesome history as a royal prison and execution site. The walls of this fortress have witnessed the tragic ends of some of England's most notable figures. Among its infamous residents was Anne Boleyn, the ill-fated second wife of King Henry VIII, who was beheaded here in 1536. The young princes in the tower, Edward V and his brother Richard of York, disappeared within these stone walls, their fate a mystery that still haunts the nation. Over the centuries, the tower has earned a reputation for ghostly sightings and paranormal phenomena. Anne Boleyn is said to haunt the chapel of St. Peter ad Vincula, where she was buried, and has been spotted carrying her head under her arm. The ghostly figures of the lost princes have been reported, seen clutching each other in fear. And so, the Tower of London stands, a monument to the darker side of history, its stone walls echoing with the cries and whispers of the past. Dear viewers, as we delve into the stories of the tower, we challenge you to imagine yourself within its cold stone walls. Picture the flickering torchlight, the echoing footsteps in the corridors, the chilling sense of dread. What would you feel, knowing that your fate was uncertain, that the shadow of the axe loomed large? As we journey through our list of haunting destinations, remember, each place holds a story that transcends time. A story of power, betrayal, fear, and sometimes, a glimpse into the supernatural. The Tower of London awaits, its ghostly residents ready to share their tales. Are you brave enough to listen? From the historic fortress of England, we cross the Atlantic to find ourselves in the heart of Louisiana, USA. Welcome to our number 3 haunting destination, the Myrtles Plantation. This grand southern mansion, built in 1796 by General David Bradford, is often dubbed as one of America's most haunted homes. Nestled amidst the sprawling greenery, it may seem a picture of tranquility, but don't let its serene beauty fool you. The Myrtles Plantation is steeped in chilling tales of murder, mystery, and restless spirits. One of the most infamous legends is that of Chloe, a slave who supposedly poisoned the family of Judge Clark Woodruff in revenge for his illicit advances. Although there is no historical evidence of Chloe's existence, guests and staff alike report sightings of a woman in a green turban, who they believe to be Chloe's spirit. Another haunting tale is that of the ghostly children seen playing on the veranda or the phantom footsteps echoing through the halls. Some believe these are the spirits of the Woodruff children, who tragically died young. While the allure of these stories has turned the Myrtles Plantation into a hotspot for paranormal tourism, it's also stirred up controversy. Critics argue that ghost hunting tends to romanticize the brutal history of slavery, overshadowing the real human suffering that took place. As we delve into the mysteries of the Myrtles Plantation, we invite you, dear viewers, to ponder upon these stories. Imagine the grandeur of this southern Gothic mansion, contrasted with the eerie chill of unseen presences. Can you hear the phantom laughter of ghostly children, or the soft rustle of a spectral figure passing by? What do you make of these tales? Do they send a shiver down your spine, or do you dismiss them as mere folklore? The Myrtles Plantation beckons, its spectral inhabitants eager to tell their tales. Are you ready to step into this haunting slice of American history, where the echoes of the past linger in every corner? From the spectral whispers of America, we now journey to the heart of Transylvania, Romania. Welcome to our number 2 haunting destination, Bran Castle, often associated with the infamous legend of Dracula. This imposing fortress, perched high on a rocky cliff, is shrouded in a mist of mystery and vampire lore. Bran Castle is not just an architectural marvel, but a symbol of Romania's turbulent history. Although the castle was not the residence of the real-life Vlad the Impaler, the man who inspired Bram Stoker's Dracula, it is often linked to him due to its eerie resemblance to Stoker's descriptions of Dracula's castle. Vlad the Impaler, known for his gruesome deeds and his penchant for impaling his enemies, was a Wallachian prince who lived in the 15th century. His bloodthirsty reign and his nickname Dracula, meaning Son of the Dragon, inspired the creation of the world's most famous vampire. As we step into the dimly lit corridors of Bran Castle, we can almost feel the chill of the ancient stone walls, echoing with whispers of the past. The creaking wooden floors, the musty scent of centuries-old dust, and the eerie silence that envelops the castle adds to the mystique of this haunting destination. Despite the chilling atmosphere, Bran Castle is a treasure trove of history and folklore. As we wander through its labyrinthine passages, we'll find antique furniture, weapons, and armor on display, each piece narrating a tale from the past. So, dear viewers, what do you think? Are you ready to embrace your inner vampire and explore this iconic landmark? Can you separate the fact from fiction in The Legend of Dracula? Do you feel the shivers running down your spine, or are you intrigued by the rich history of Bran Castle? As you ponder these questions, remember, every shadow, every creak, might just be Dracula, watching and waiting in his eerie lair. Leaving the vampire's lair behind, we embark on a journey across the Atlantic to our number one haunting destination, Salem, Massachusetts, USA. Often referred to as the Witch City, Salem is infamous for the dark chapter in its history, the Salem Witch Trials of 1692. This small New England town became the epicenter of a moral panic that resulted in the execution of 20 people, all accused of practicing witchcraft. Today, the echoes of those tragic events still linger in the town's cobblestone streets and centuries-old buildings. Our exploration begins at the Salem Witch Trials Memorial, a solemn reminder of the innocent lives lost during the witch hunt. Each stone bench in the memorial is inscribed with the name of a victim, a haunting testament to the fear and hysteria that once gripped this town. As we wander through the memorial, the chilling echoes of the past seem almost tangible. From there, we venture to the Witch House, the only structure in Salem directly connected to the trials. This eerie, black-clad building was once the home of Judge Jonathan Corwin, who presided over the trials. The creaking floors and low ceilings of this 17th-century house add to its ghostly aura. Salem's haunting past has transformed it into a magnet for those fascinated by the occult. The town is dotted with witch-themed shops, museums, and attractions, including the Salem Witch Museum and the Witch Dungeon Museum. These establishments delve into the history of the trials, the misconceptions about witchcraft, and the cultural impact of the events that unfolded in Salem. Despite its dark history, Salem has evolved into a place of learning and reflection. The town's tragic past serves as a stark reminder of the dangers of mass hysteria and the importance of due process. The ghostly whispers of Salem's past continue to echo, teaching us valuable lessons about fear, justice, and the human capacity for harm. As we conclude our journey through Salem, stay tuned as we have a bonus haunting destination that you could visit up next. We invite you to ponder on these lessons. Are you captivated by the town's eerie charm, or are you chilled to the bone by its tragic past? As you wander through the streets of Salem, remember, every whisper of the wind might just be a plea from a spirit of the past, seeking justice and understanding. And now, we're blazing a trail across the country to the Wild West. Welcome, dear viewers, to our bonus final haunting destination you could visit, Bodie, California, USA. This once thriving mining town, now a state historic park, is a true ghost town, preserved in a state of arrested decay. The eerie silence that fills the air here is a stark contrast to the bustling activity of the late 1800s, when gold was discovered in the hills nearby. At its peak, Bodie was home to around 10,000 residents and over 2,000 buildings. But as the gold rush faded, so did Bodie. By the 1940s, it was virtually abandoned, leaving behind a ghostly shell of its former self. As we stroll down the deserted streets past the dilapidated buildings and rusting mining equipment, it's almost as if time has stood still. The town's church, its windows now devoid of glass, still stands tall, a symbol of faith amidst the desolation. The schoolhouse, with its desks gathering dust, echoes with the laughter of children long gone. The saloon, once filled with the clink of glasses and the hum of miners celebrating their finds, is now just a hollow shell. But it's not just the ghostly buildings that make Bodie a haunting destination. Tales of apparitions and unexplained phenomena abound. Some say the spirits of Bodie's residents still roam the town, forever trapped in their quest for gold. There's the infamous ghost of a little girl who died in a tragic accident said to haunt the town's cemetery. And then there's the chilling tale of the Bodie Curse, a warning to those who dare to take anything from the town. Many who've taken a souvenir have returned it, claiming to have experienced a string of bad luck. So, are you brave enough to visit Bodie, or perhaps you've already experienced the town's eerie charm? As we wrap up our journey through some of the world's most haunting destinations, we'd love to hear your spooky travel tales. Have you visited a place that gave you chills? Or maybe you've had a paranormal encounter of your own? Drop a comment below and share your stories with us. Remember, the world is full of mysteries waiting to be uncovered, and sometimes the most haunting tales are the ones we live ourselves. Thanks for joining us on this eerie exploration. Until next time, keep that curiosity alive, stay safe, and remember, adventure is always just around the corner.